हेलो गाइस, हाउ यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड. सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ द फाइनल पार्ट ऑफ आवर रैकनेटिव फायरबेस सीरीज, 14th पार्ट. सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट क्रैशलिटिक्स, हाउ वी कैन यूज दिस इन आवर रैकनेटिव एप्लीकेशंस एंड व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग दिस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट डज इट डू? Basically, Crashlytics helps us to collect analytics and details about crashes and errors that occur in your app. It does this through three aspects. First one is logs, second one is crash reports, third one is stack traces. So logs are log events in your app to be sent with the crash report for context if your app crashed. Crash reports are every crash is automatically turned into a crash report and sent. Third one, stack trace. Even when an error is caught and your app recovers, the JavaScript stack trace can still be sent. It means if your application crash and it closes and exit after error, it crashes, and then when you restart your application, stack trace can still be sent. So how we can use this? So first of all, what we have to do is install its module. We already have that module, so install this in our application. Yarn add React Native Firebase Crashlytics. It's installing. After that, npx pod install for iOS platform to install pods for this pod dependencies. It will take some time to install. Okay, so uses of this is record errors, crash, logs. Its name is Crashlytics because it's record crashes as well as analytics. So something same as analytics. In Crashlytics, we can use analytics also for something like this, set user ID. Suppose you are just logging into your application and you return user ID, and you can pass that using this Crashlytics dot set user ID and inside that user ID, and you can add custom attributes like set dot set attributes same as this, and if you have an object you can pass like this. So let's see, it's installed, it's still installing. Okay, now what we have to do is let's try to run the application. If the app crashes, it means something is wrong, because you can see once installed you must complete the following additional setup steps for Android. If you are using an older version of React Native without auto linking support or wish to integrate info and existing sorry into an existing project, you can follow the manual installation. So we are using a newer version of React Native, so auto linking is supported here. So we need to install this module, and after that we need to follow these additional steps using that link. Let's see, application is working or crashing. And one thing, friends, because this is the last part of this Firebase series, some of your friends are saying to me that they need phone authentication and Facebook authentication video. So I will create that also. But that videos will be excluded from this series because all the modules, mostly all of the modules are done after this video. So I have already that videos in my pipeline in the list of videos I have to create yet. So definitely I will create videos for both phone authentication and Facebook authentication using Firebase in React Native application. So for that, stay updated with my channel. So application installed. Installing, you can see application crashed. That's why we required this additional steps. Click on this link, it will open this here. What we have to do, if you are migrated from Fabric, make sure you remove the Fabric properties right file from your Android project. So we don't have that, so nothing to do with this. So first of all, add the Google repository if it's not there already in Android build Gradle file. Let's go to that file, Android, then build Gradle. Inside build script, Google is already there, so we don't need to add this. Next, add the Firebase Crashlytics plugin dependency. Copy this Android inside build.gradle folder. Under this here, okay, I just added it. Now save it. Next is apply the Firebase Crashlytics plugin to your application inside Android app build.gradle file. Let's open this first here, this one, and below this we need to add, you can see apply after this line, because Google services should be before this. Copy this to apply the plugin and import and apply it here. Done. Then this is optional, enable Crashlytics NDK reporting in same file build.gradle inside app folder. Just copy this, it's optional but not mandatory. Let's see where it is. Build types release. Build type release here. In this, we can add it here like this. Okay, but it's not mandatory, it's just optional. So, what I have added here. Next, rebuild the project. Okay, once the above steps have been completed, rebuild your project and run that application again. Close this for now. Let's see what's happening now. Application crashes or it runs successfully. Let's see. If it runs successfully, then we are sure that Crashlytics is already implemented and in right manner. So let's see, it's compiling, configuring, it's failed. What's the error is Crashlytics could not determine stripped unstripped native library variant release when NDK will. So for that, if it's give error, let's remove this. We can comment this. Let's try now. Maybe that for release build, because we are creating a debug build here. Let's see. It should work now. Yep, it's installing Crashlytics. We just see here. Okay, let's install this. After that, what we can do with this? So suppose there is a method. Where I can show you. On which page? Okay, suppose let's say on analytics page. Let me show it on your analytics page. So use effect. Inside that, just call a function. Name it as get user details. Okay, now create that function here. Const get user details. So we have that function, and inside that we will create a promise, so we can get error as well as response. So let's see, application install, it's still working. So let me show you, resolve promise. This one. Let's copy this. Suppose we have a function here. And it will return resolve for success. And reject for error. I'm not creating any HTTP call or something like that from where I can get response. I just showing you demo. So now okay, so you can see I have created then block here and catch block. So in this catch block we know we can get our error. So when we call reject in our function, it will goes to the catch block. So inside this, we can record error something like that. You can see try and catch block are there. So you can use try catch also, what I have showed you using promise. So import Crashlytics, or you can copy this here. Application launched. See, application working fine now because we have did that additional configuration for Android one. So that's why application installed now. So let's continue from here. Crashlytics, inside this Crashlytics dot record error, it will record error. Just pass that error inside this. Got it? So we can record error like that. Error reports. Okay. Suppose in success function you got user ID, then you can use Crashlytics dot set user ID and pass that user ID here. Okay. And if you are getting object from that response, then you can pass Crashlytics dot set attribute for single thing like user name, and here will be the name of username. Means this will be the name, this will be the value. Okay, if you have multiple values, you can use set attributes and pass that object here like name. I think here they have gave example like this. If you have multiple values from response, if you have single value return from response, okay, to set user ID. Okay, so you can use that one by one using this multiple instead of this multiple attributes. So you can use also one by one set attribute function, but I recommend if you have multiple values, you can use set attributes like this. So next, there are lots of things in this use effect. We know that our this analytics page is mounted. For that we can use a log here that analytics page just mounted. Okay, save it, and we know inside return we can analytics page just unmounted. We can set log like that. So we have done with logs, set user ID, set attributes, record error, and what else they have showed here? crashlytics.crash. I think we can use that here also. Let's see. Cause your app to crash for testing purposes. This is a native crash and will not contain a JavaScript stack trace. So using this application, can we natively crash? So let's see why also this. Which one is this page? Analytics. Click on this. Get user to, because it's a not a here method. Undefined is dot then is not there because I think something is wrong here. Something is missing from that promise in TypeScript. We are doing right. Maybe something is wrong, but it's just an example. You can do something like that, or we can do try catch block also. Try inside that and catch that. Like this. We can use try catch block also, as they did here. You can see. Inside catch error. Okay, so now it should be like this. Yeah. And this will be like this. Yeah, you can remove this and this. Got it? It is the other way without promises. Try and catch blocks are there, record error. So let's save this and go to that page analytics again. Click on this. Now we are here. So inside this crashlytics dot crash, it means application should be crash when we are on this page. Let's see. I think it's and then crashes. Let's try again. Click on this. Analytics. You can see application is crashes and we are unable to go back. So it is caused by this crashlytics.crash. So uncomment this. Let's try now. Close the application. Go to analytics again. Back, you can see it's working now. This caused the application crashes. So most of done with this crashlytics module. So also from firebase.json file, you can disable auto collection by setting this crashlytics auto collection enabled to false. By default it's true. Enable debug crash logs. You can enable or disable in debug mode for crashes and crashlytics NDK enabled or not. You can set that also in firebase.json. But one thing is important. I have did all the things, most of the things from this module, but before everything, go to Firebase console. You must enable that crashlytics from side menu. Go to crashlytics, Firebase demo, and enable Crashlytics. Add the SDK, then build, run, and crash your app. View the SDK docs. We were listening from your app to communicate with our servers. Let's see. We have crashed here already. This 35 line number. Now go to analytics again. It's crashed. So why it's not listening? Let's refresh. I think it will take some time, but it should not be. We are listening for your application to communicate with our servers, but we just crashed the application here. Crashed. Let me close that here. Crashed. Application is crashed. You can see installation is successful because they have read that crash is just called inside your application. This one. So that's why they are saying installation is successful. Go to Crashlytics dashboard. So two crashes are there. This is the error where it crashes line number 62 inside this, that. So you can get Crashlytics error inside your Firebase console. Events type crashes. So also you can get analytics inside that also. These are the event which triggered is crashes here. User affected one, non-fatals user affected. Search by user ID. There are lots of things here. So this is the thing which we have to show in this video. So Crashlytics is the last video of this React Native Firebase tutorial series. So friends, I hope you like the whole series. Now I will push that all the code to the GitHub and will let you know, and I will add that link to the description of each video of Firebase tutorial series. So friends, if you like this Firebase series, please share, subscribe and like the videos, subscribe our channel. So friends, if you have queries, you can join me on Telegram group. Link is in description. And also, if you have some demands like videos, like someone said to me that he need Facebook authentication and phone authentication in Firebase, React Native Firebase, so I will create that videos also that are in my pipeline of the videos list. So friends, take care. Bye bye. Thank you so much, friend. Bye.